top eight, Sonic Fox versus Combat. This is a match that we've actually seen before this year. This was actually an online match that we saw very early on in the game's lifespan between Fox and Combat. And Combat was actually able to win that tournament. It was kind of his real kind of breakout performance with Johnny Cage. Now, fast forward, the clock's about a year. We're seeing a very different match now. Of course, Combat has had a lot more experience under his belt by this point. Has really kind of settled on the Johnny Cage and Gearest duo. And Sonic Fox, I mean, they have been bringing quite the show with Ace of Knaves Joker all day. And at this point, I'd be very surprised if we see anything else. As you can see right up there, it is Joker versus Johnny Cage. This is exactly what we expected. Fox is on a mission. They want to be able to win two world finals back to back with the same character in two different games. And we can definitely see that. Johnny Cage versus Joker, game one of this top eight. It's going to be an interesting matchup right here. There's a lot of range, a lot of good buttons, but a lot of damage. Interestingly, the two characters in the game that can cancel their fatal blow. Now, this will be unique because they are the only characters in the game that can do that. And it opens up so much of their offense when they get low that they're very comeback heavy, right? They're very built for it. Whereas Johnny Cage is more of that kind of like space control, kind of really good buttons, as well as that comeback. It really is Ace of Knaves. It's more of just a mix-up, rushed out, or it's set play character. And that really fits Sonic Fox like a glove.
Now the corner, this is where Fox wants you. Joker's buttons, the 2-1 is fantastic. Ace of Knaves getting those launchers and the setup tools. Absolute nightmare situation if he backs to the corner. Speaking of which, grab, gonna get a knockdown into decent positioning. And that 2-1, just the magic string. And you're gonna see that a lot from Fox here.
Okay, getting clipped on the way up. Good wake-up attack, give Sonic Fox the advantage, the safety. Hang on a minute. Oh, and we're just talking about that cancel. Combat comes off it straight away for a bit confirm. Chunky damage.
Goes in for the meaty down one, Rising Star. Fox is gonna get hit by the cancel again. Round one, we saw two fatal blow cancels. I say get used to seeing that a lot throughout the course of the series.
Round two.
Shouts to Shaolin Monks in the background.
No, Shaolin Monks.
What a game. And now, oh, looking for a single button, but Combat not going to press yet. Is going to stick out that low all the same. The low is going to connect once more. Those graphics got smaller.
Ah, there we go. We're back. We're back.
Ooh, Johnny Cage with the Magna Arm.
I like the way Combat is playing this. He's completely slowed things down. I feel like the worst thing you can do is just get really impatient and just give yourself to someone like Sonic Fox. Oh, and the second Combat decides to be the one to start how things are going, immediate whiff punish into crushing blow. That's exactly why Combat has been more defensive in this round, and it's really paying off.
And immediately, another Rising Star's gonna do the job. One round each at this point, and Combat, what really started that sequence was a wake-up neutral jump. The hard reads, you've just gotta have those guttural decisions. Whiff, oh no!
Speaking
this
of which,
is Ace of Knaves.
Yeah,
there's
a big combo opportunity. Oh, the backup as well, maybe trying to scout out the roll.
Oh, the delay, the held. Clipped by the low again, Combat.
Oh, counter hit too, yeah, Sonic Fox just trying to press something off the ground, but Combat said absolutely not.
And he knows Fox is going to respect the frames. Runs in and enforces a grab almost immediately. Get out of there, interactable. Sticking out the low again, loads of patience. Ooh, Fox.
Oh, he tried to whiff punish, but not close enough. That's wow. A big hit though, no bar to get more damage, but keeps the life lead nonetheless.
The raw jump in. Almost catching entirely, but the down four does recover just in time. Here comes the mid. This mid string, there is that overhead that you know Fox. They're not shy of pulling the trigger. The tech, the dirty tech. Remember, forward throw. If the fatal blows
oh,
on cooldown.
Speaking of which, that's going to be the round.
Close your eyes.
Oh. Oh.
This is a family show for crying out loud. Now immediately. What we saw there was just, I assume here, admin's probably just mentioning to lower the health bars.
I imagine they're just going to go quickly and lower the health bars, of course. Thank you very much for being patient with us. But a good game one for Sonic Fox. That Joker, that Ace of Knaves Joker, really showing why it can be so dangerous in the hands of a good player, right? It ticks so much of the boxes. There are a lot of similarities to be made between Joker and Johnny Cage in terms of like overall range and just kind of neutral options. But then Ace of Knaves really kind of throws on. Originally, most of us just assumed it would be a very kind of mix-up heavy, like primarily set play. Whereas I feel like, even though that's still there for Ace of Knaves, it's not really the main point of the variation. It's about kind of just keeping your turn as opposed to constant mix-ups.
You also get a perfect example over why the Joker has arguably the scariest fatal blow game in the game, because the tech, you know, Combat made the amazing read to tech the throw, and then the next grab still crushing blow because it takes a while for fatal blow to actually come back, and this cooldown's gonna benefit. Flawless block. Combat bringing out the clutch execution, and now
Now, that's actually another interesting dynamic we see here, though, because you have Sonic Fox who, when you watch Sonic Fox play, they flawless block barely ever at all, like, if ever. It's so rare. And you have someone like Combat that is very much a flawless block master. So that's really going to be interesting to see how that makes a difference here, because that was huge. That entire sequence started off flawless blocking a wake-up attack.
And it forces Fox onto the back foot. When Combat's able to kind of get the keys in the ignition, Johnny Cage is a momentum character, and that's a trade. Very expensive down two to obtain. No full combo.
The Amplified got some damage, but lost all that defensive bar. That's definitely not what you want to see, especially when you're back to the wall like this. Sonic Fox kind of keeping that pressure about sweet distance. Doesn't want to get too close and let Combat get out for free.
Always keep an eye on that Amplified Jack in the box. It tests your matchup knowledge massively. In that situation, Combat tried to trade. Flawless block up two. No jump in for you, mate. But now the low again blocked. You can scout the low into overhead. It's very tight, though. Very tight. Speaking of overhead, Bird Boy beatdown's going to connect. Remember, three of those on Amplify, the next one meatlessly, crushing blows.
And we've seen Sonic Fox use that crushing blow perfectly all of the day, so you know absolutely that they are keeping count of how many they've got.
Now projectile game. Combat's going to be pretty careful with this. The range of the forward 2-1 makes those projectiles kind of scary. No counter hit though, so there's not going to be a crushing blow there.
Ooh. Now, I like that choice. Even though Combat is losing, every time Sonic Fox has gone for the box in the neutral, Combat has just responded with forceful straight away. No, that must have been a mistake. Going to hold that. That was either an execution error or like a next level read. Maybe Fox is going to move in.
I'm inclined to think execution error purely because of how much health that Fox had left.
Yeah, for
even
sure.
The fatal blow connecting there would have been arguably a little bit of a waste. Commits into the nut punch. Not going to hit its mark, unfortunately. Fox too patient, and the mid again, Amplify. We're building towards that crushing blow. Really turns Joker into a win condition character.
And this is what we were saying before about it's not really kind of set play mix-up. It's more about just keeping a box under your opponent, so it's always your turn. It's about just constantly making the read like, oh, is he going to press? Is he going to block? Do I get to move? Do I have to press a button? Like, it's so hard to deal with in the heat of the moment. Big jump kick. Simple confirm. Going to take a nice chunk of damage there as Combat.
The Amplified backboard boy really does just reset things, creates that automatic disengage back to neutral. But Fox, they have the life lead. This is where they want to be. Escape, they try to tech the grab, but remember, grabs, they are in turn 50-50s for Tekken. Now the force ball game. Combat, bit by bit,
Fox
bringing himself back into
for that
it.
Advancing high so much. But long armor, the Joker.
Fox has Fatal Blow. That's what they want. No cancel, though. We can definitely see the end of a game. If a clean opening comes here, the Fatal Blow is going to be the Skeleton Key for the damage. The cancel. 1, 2, 3. It's safe on block. And from this point, both players, Fatal Blows will be ready. Fox, the backboard forward, just waste enough time allow another one. Oh, no. Feels so good.
Just about enough damage there, you could say, just about.
Fox played the end of that game perfectly, using two of the backboard fours on Amp to just waste time. We had about 4 seconds, roughly, for the Fatal Blow to come back. The two offensive bars used just to guarantee the time is there, and then when the Fatal Blow comes back,
that's one of the scariest things about the Joker, right? That kind of like jumping jack. That's a universal move. That's really plus on block if you amplify it. Your opponent kind of has to deal with it. And with the tools of Ace of Knaves at the same time, right? The Jack in the Box underneath and the long buttons. It's scary.
Absolutely. Combat, I mean, he's been playing fantastically this series too. It's just Fox, the Fatal Blow game is just so strong. And it's really kind of that trump card. Two times in a row, challenge the Amplified Jack in the Box and you pay the price. No punish. I mean, that could have been much more than it was.
Oh, okay.
No overhead.
Fox is really fishing for that. Bird Boy beatdown really wants to get the crushing blow ready.
Fatal Blow's in play.
Oh no! Ask and you shall receive. Okay, so this does like a billion damage. I wonder if this is actually going to kill.
It is.
I think
this
might.
One of the highest damage Fatal Blows in the game. My word! Have a look at the damage.
Oh my goodness!
That's a lot of damage for a two-hit.
Goodness!
Confirm, Mustard.
Bro, two hits into Fatal Blow, 43%.
Let's go.
The Joker's not very fair, is he? He's a mean guy.
The Joker doesn't play fair. Here we go. Potentially match point here for Fox.
That's huge.
Came
that
to
is
the
huge.
Chin. That cost him his jaw right there. Here we go, more Amplify. Every single time that connects, Combat's going to sweat more and more because the damage of the crushing blow.
That's
speaking
another
of which,
one. I think that's it. The crushing blow must be there by now.
And one more clean opening. Combat's basically dead.
Oh, no. Okay, was one off. Even Sonic Fox thought it was going to be there, but Combat throwing a lifeline. Okay, I can actually maybe make a comeback. Dash cancel.
Remember, this is outtake. There's no camera, there's no shades crushing blow. To work projectiles, that jump kick hurts big time. And just right there, combat, a little bit lost, don't do it. Surely not. There we go, yeah. But I say, there is a 0% chance.
Were you expecting, like, the Jack of Box into Mercy?
Oh,
yeah, can we talk about this fatality for a second? I mean,